least follow, try to follow the color code. And the other side will, it should be like Y configuration. And from here to the neutral. For the measurement, you can take one face from here, the red one, and implement it again here. So this will take care of like for the measure the current, and for the measuring the voltage, that will be like parallel, so the current will be like in series, and for voltage will be in parallel. So now the connection to like complete, since we take the measurement only for one phase, you can just switch, because it is required to take the current, voltage, frequency, B and Q. So one phase, it's just enough, okay? So you can start by 300, as it's mentioned here, and then when you're done and take all the measurement, current, voltage, frequency, switch to 600, and then 1200. Okay, I will show you now how to like take the measurement by the software. So from the acquisition data, you need to connect to the DC here. So the software, it's called LVDAC. Once you enter LV, it will be the first option. Maybe you will hear like a small sound like that indicates there is a like link.
for example. You need to like energize this one.
That's why. There is some.
Okay. So this is like the measure for the voltage, and this is the current. Okay. That's how you take the voltage and the current. If you want to measure the power, you need to go in anyone. For example, we want to close this one and we choose the power. There is many like options. You can choose the power. And also here the power, and from this one you can switch to reactive power, real power, apparent power, depends to what you want. And for frequency, same thing. We just pick the frequency and it will be appearing. Okay? This is how you take the like the measurement. The second part or the second scenario, you want to add inductive load to the resistive load. So you need to like turn off this one. It will be in series. You need just to switch the Y configuration to upper side. And from the output from the resistive load will be in input for the inductive load. Same thing with the capacitive load. You just you need, but then when you take the all the measurement, you switch from here to here. And same thing here, just switch to here to make the resistive load in series with the capacitive load. And of course, the second part, when the load become like complex, you need for the resistive, you just keep it on 300 and switch only one phase, which it has the ammeter and the voltage measurement. You need to like switch it 300, take the measurement, 600, take the measurement, 1200, take the measurement. Okay, this is will like cover the first part. The second part, any question in this?
Okay. When you increase the load, you only do it to one of the loads or to all three?
So like when you we just are talking about like the complex resistive and for example inductive, okay? So you just keep, as it mentioned, like in the lab, you keep all the phases in 300, okay? and ohm, and for just the phase, this one you need to like make it first like 300, take the measurement, and then 600 and 1200.
And you only do that to one of them, you don't have to do it to...
No, because I need just one phase. So the second part will cover the synchronized machine. So the synchronized machine, it can work as like a motor or generator. Like take the input like electrical power and provide mechanical power, or vice versa. So in our lab today, we'll deal with the synchronous machine as motor. Okay, so we'll provide like electrical power to the motor, and the output of the motor will be go to the like dynamometer as a load, as a mechanical load. So I would start with the Y configuration. So we have like two sides of the station, like the this is the rotor and this is the stationary coil, I think. Yeah. So you need to make the Y configuration on this side in 4, 5, 6 and connect it to the neutral. But please keep it in the adjustable like power supply, not on the fixed, because we need to like manipulate on this. So as an input, we need to like connect for this one, the red color of phase one, you just take it to the ammeter, because we need the ammeter to be in series. And from here, you just connect it to this side. For the rotor, winding, we need to like this is the DC, just connect it here. Make sure the exciter disconnected. Okay. Same thing with the voltage. The same phase with the neutral. I think good to go. Sometimes, if you saw this like not ready, maybe you need like to close the software and. Sometimes it works. Okay. Switch. Okay. Mm.
to power the dynamometer. Each station has its own like cables. Also, we need one other cable to get the measurement of the speed and torque from the dynamometer, similar to this device. Okay, I believe once we like increase, you can hear the sound. Like this is the beginning of the, and you can see the speed here. You need to like rise the. Also, until you reach the full power supply to the generator, but still it doesn't like reach the synchronized speed like 1800. To reach the synchronized speed, you need to connect the exciter here, then it will be like 1800. This is the synchronized speed. And to increase the voltage, you need to increase the DC current to the rotor field or winding until the maximum. And there is some measurement you need to take it from here. There is three scenario here. First scenario, you connect the dynamometer by cable to the software, then the dynamometer, you can recognize the dynamometer here, just one click, connect. So this is the dynamometer, this is the hour speed, and this is the torque. For the torque, but to activate the dynamometer, or to control the dynamometer, through the software, you need to click this one, the start and stop. once you click activate the software control on the diameter, you can drive the torque from this knob. You can see it's increased, but please don't like increase it more than one. Less than two at the top. So for first scenario, you need to like adjust the DC current for the rotor until you get the reactive power zero. Okay? Once the reactive power reached to the zero, then you can increase the torque. I need like 10, let's say 10 readings. Okay? You can start from zero or the minimum like value for the torque and increase it until you got like 10 readings, but don't exceed the torque more than 2. Okay? And you will get like your measurement, like all the measurements that indicate here. Second scenario, you need to like go all the way down with the rotor DC current and do same thing, increase the torque for 10 like readings and increase the torque to get like 10 readings. And the third scenario, you need to like to go all the way to the maximum in the like DC like current and the rotor and do the same thing, like increase the torque from here and you collect like 10 readings again. Okay? That's all for this lab. If anything, like a struggle with anything, I will be here. Good luck.